Holy greetings to all of you. At this time, I would like to invite Brother Clinton C., one of my brothers of our church. He is also one of our male ministry leaders. I want to invite him to come and have greetings this morning. Give him a hearty amen.
I just want to say Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers and remind you to remember that you are diplomats and intermediaries between Jesus and your children, and you're doing a good job. And let's not forget that. But also I want to remind you to remember the fathers who inspired you and gave you that little lift into becoming a mother.
Amen.
And I know some people are offended when people say, I got the greatest mother in the whole wide world. I suggest you say this, as I say to my mother. My mother greatest mother to me in my whole wide world. Say that, and you'll never offend anybody. God bless you. Have a
God bless you. Thank you, sir. Who often refer to motherly as in other forms, is a mother of our church. We recognize that you have graced us, you have led us, and we appreciate you. Would you give us the official mother's greeting on this morning? Let us together give our hearty amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
We all should be very happy that God has blessed us to see another day.
Amen.
I am standing here because I received a call from down south this morning, wishing me Happy Mother's Day, and she requests that I would stand and announce to St. James that she still loves you and she misses you, and she wanted to tell all the mothers a Happy Mother's Day. That was none other than the apple of Cain. Says he missed you very much. And I just want to say, he said, give me your flowers while I'm here. I just want to thank my son. I knew he loved me, but words mean a lot. And I say to all the mothers, Happy Mother's Day. But I want the young people to remember this. My mother taught me when I was very young. I remember. M is for the many things she taught me. O means only that she's growing old. T is for the tears she shed to save me. H is for her heart, pure than gold. E is for her eyes with love light shining. And Ara means right, and right mama always be. I put them all together. They spell mother, a word that means the world to me. God bless you.
Amen. Names this morning, such as Mother Elizabeth Derry, Mother Sally Anderson, and we've mentioned all others. I remember my mom, and you remember your mom, for those who are in heavenly places. Love goes beyond time and space. Love is the substance of God's grace. And moms, you'll forever remember your smiling faces. We're all going to prepare to see you at the end of the race. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
A godly mother with godly care has God's help when she sighs for prayer. God's masterpiece. God took the fragrance of a flower, the majesty of a tree, the gentleness of morning dew, the calm of a quiet sea, the beauty of the twilight hour, the soul of a starry night, the laughter of a rippling brook, the grace of a bird in flight. Then God fashioned from these things a creation like no other. And when his masterpiece was through, he called it simply Mother. Happy Mother's Day to all. God bless you and have an awesome, wonderful, blessed day.
At the same time, I have been blessed with a great woman in my life. And I want to thank God for my wife. My wife, Heather Vines DeBose, the First Lady of St. James Missionary Baptist Church. And I want to tell her I love her and Happy Mother's Day. good. Trust me, this is the one time the Reverend can say all the time, all by himself. Amen. Amen. Thank you all. I want to also make this recognition that there are many who are mothers who have not birthed a child, but mother many individuals. I want to say to you also, God bless you and happy Mother's Day. Thank you. Amen. Let's go to the Word of God. Deuteronomy 2, one of our newest moms of the church. Amen. She's smiling, and we're proud. Amen. That is a sign of great health, the church, great health, the family. Why don't you stand? Let's see your loved one, newest mom here at St. James. Let's give the both of them a hearty amen. Praise be the Lord. God bless you. I'm excited. He's going to be put into the hands of the pastor of the second Sunday in June. In the morning service. God bless you. You may rest. I'm excited about that time of blessing him on that day. Deuteronomy, the 6th chapter. This morning I'm asking for a reader this morning. Someone who would share in reading the scripture for me with loud voice. Praise be the name of the Lord. Deuteronomy, the 6th chapter, verses 4 through 9. The 6th chapter of Deuteronomy, 4 through 9. The 6th chapter of Deuteronomy 4 through 9. May I ask the mom of my home? Amen. Amen. You said if you want to, just read that for the pastor as I prepare for an exhortation on this Mother's Day. We're still in a healthy hour and still before noon. Deuteronomy, the 6th chapter, verses 4 through 9.
I will be reading from the New King James Version. And verse 4 reads, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. And these words, which I command you today, shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. You shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates.
Amen. The ultimate home security system. It's what I want to share with you today on this Mother's Day. Not only are we sharing in St. James Sanctuary today, we use the ether waves and we use mediums that others all over the world are watching this ministry. We say to you out there, God bless you on this Mother's Day 2016. The ultimate home security system, our mom. Usher, she may rest in the presence of God. A few weeks ago, I was blessed to be able to attend, as we have been in this third season, the third week of conventions. I began with the New England Missionary Baptist Convention. I recall the delegates of the St. James Missionary Baptist Church, along with the pastor and family. One particular evening, we all decided to get in our vehicles together, Sister Martha, Mom, and we rode through Washington, D.C. together that afternoon evening. What a refreshing time we had together. And I invite you all, whenever we leave Norwalk, to come abroad with us that we can have trips together in the name of the Lord. I remember before we decided to go to Howard University, they kind of laughed at me that evening. Even Deja smiling now. Watching how I recounted certain areas, I cried when I went to the tree that I used to stand in front of and saw the chapel and took them to my college and certain areas that meant so much to me. Before we all silently argued about what restaurant we wanted to go to that evening, the pastor tried to keep his mouth shut, but nevertheless, we found one, didn't we? And it was a nice Mexican restaurant. I want y'all to recall, and as I tell them the story, how we were driving through those communities. I saw, though we were in and on the gate of a hood called Washington, D.C., immediately afterwards, there was a community that was so beautiful and refreshing. I mean, the houses were like mansions. I saw gates all the way up around the houses, fencing the homes. I saw these tall iron gates that swung open with private security guards, amen, that would have to clear you for admission onto their property. Well, I say today that I was impressed. I was impressed when I saw that. I mean, we were firmly convinced, amen, as I thought about it, that I really don't want to live a life like that. A life so sheltered, you know, it's a startling contrast in being in an open community like we have here at St. James, where you can walk out and others can see you, and you can see others. Others have their space, and you have your space, but it's a shared space amongst each other. It's all the complete opposite than what I was used to, some of us who know what South means, when you can, amen, leave your key and your ignition. Don't worry about putting deadbolts on your door. Can anybody out there with me? We're a totally different community. Today, few communities remain in our countries that's like that one that I left, or like the community we used to live with in Heather in New Canaan. Though Heather used to remind me, though we're in New Canaan, the town logo was a stop before heaven. Don't you take that for granted. You better lock the house. You better take your keys in the car. There is a thief, but this thesis statement, the point, whose primary target is not your money or securities or your jewelry. I'm talking about the ultimate home security system. There is a thief. He wants to steal your mind. He wants your children. Jesus says, in John 10:10 wins. The thief comes only, did he say only?
Only.
Say it one more time.
Only.
To steal, kill, and destroy. Oh, yeah. But Jesus says, I have come. Do I have a witness up in here? Yeah. That you might have life and have it to the fullness. And a newspaper ran a story about a burglar who broke into a house and lived there for 4 years before the residents discovered it. When the family was home, the intruder lived quietly in the attic. And when they went out, he had the run of the whole house. He cooked his meals in their kitchen. He ate their food. He read their books and watched their television. The residents had no idea someone was living with them. Perhaps your worst enemy is already living in your house, and you don't realize it. His presence is proved by the television programs we watch, or the books or magazines we read. He simply seduces your soul, and you have not even noticed that he lives with you. If this is the case, I must tell you that God has already provided you with a divine power to demolish, that means break and destroy, your enemy's strongholds. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
By taking captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. In 2 Corinthians 10:4-5, it talks about that. In other words, if within the walls of your home there are programs, books, magazines, conversations, or toys that distract you from the honor of the one who died on the cross to take away your sins, do your soul a favor with me today on this Mother's Day, and let's destroy them now. Praise the Lord is right. And when Moses writes in Deuteronomy 6, thanks for reading that, Heather. He said, talk about this when you sit at home. Oh, thank you, Lord, for the word. Can somebody join us and say, thank God for the word? You got to change what you talk about at home. Some of the conversations at home, God says, even then, amen, amen. He says, talk about them when you sit at home. He speaks of the commandments and the promises that God intends to secure our families against the greatest enemy. It is another way of saying that if you want your children to grow up loving God, don't expect the school to teach them Christianity. And don't presume the church will do that either in 1 or 2 weeks, hours a week, or rather, if I really calculate this right, 1 or 2 hours for the whole year. You think the church is supposed to teach the power of the Spirit? Looked at me and said, you know what, son? Somebody prayed for me. We need to sing that this morning. And somebody, and let me ask you, raise your hand by witness. You're not sitting and standing here or looking at me today because you prayed for yourself sometimes. How many will wave your hand and admit somebody prayed for you? Somebody had you on your mind, and use this time to tell the Lord thank you. Thank you, Lord, for Grandma. Thank you, Lord, for Auntie. Thank you, Lord, for that next-door neighbor who became my mom. Thank you, Lord, for that person in my life. Thank you, Lord, for that mom who I didn't like, but later on I had to go back and realize you've given me some good advice. Thank you. The ultimate home security system is found in a mom who remembers the Lord. A mom who remembered that she was created by God. A God who formed the earth and formed this world. A mom who got up every day and refreshed herself by looking in the mirror saying, God made the world and it was good. And God made me and I am good. Sometimes mom had to love herself when she was mistreated and misloved by others. Mom had to be able to fill herself with the Holy Spirit when, because of duty and request, she had to empty herself of her own womanhood and of her own strength over and over again. And when she did not find human resources to give it back to her, though they made promises to love and to fulfill and to keep and to secure, she found herself broken. But she found a God who says, you can fall into my arms. There's no hour too late. There's no morning too early. There's no situation too broken that you can't come back to me and have a God who would tell you, I love you, dear. I love you. Hold on to the best. I say to you today, I thank God for the ultimate security home system. My mom was one who was from Camden, South Carolina. She taught me some valuable things about the church. She taught me about the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. She told me, that's the book for me. She told me, you stand on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. And then my mom said, son, though you are a boy who's raised up in the church, I don't want you to be a church boy only. My mom taught me some security system things. She said, you got to know how to take care of yourself because there's a devil out there. And that devil come to kill, that devil come to steal, and that devil come to destroy. She said, you may not be able to watch your back. God got your back. But if somebody's standing in front of you, my mama told me this, I remember that day in the kitchen. She said, if somebody's standing in front of you and they hit you, you better hit them back like a hammer. You my son. She said, you better not bend down or you better not resign. I better not ever hear that you done ran away from an opportunity for you to stand at your best. And I think my mom was helping me recognize that the home security system, it starts in your own heart. It starts in your own mind. It starts in your own body. And is there anybody who out there with me got some courage because your mama told you to stand up for yourself, speak up for yourself? Time is filled with a lot of transitions. Things change. Things change. I remember when jobs would come and jobs would go, when the money would come and money would go, when things were good and things were bad, when things expected happened and then things did not happen as expected. But no matter what happened, I don't know what happened behind closed doors, but I'm so glad that whenever my mom walked out, she walked out with her feet firm on the ground. She walked out with a hope and a faith that we're going to make it, we're going to take it, and God's going to work it out. Eat your peanut butter and jelly and act like it's some spaghetti. You eat your spaghetti, you better act like it's steak. But whatever you do, you make sure you say your grace before this meal. And after you get through eating that meal, you better tell God, thank you, because it took some hard work to give you what you got. Somebody say amen. God says, say mothers and fathers and others who are listening to me, that the best home security system is the Word of God. Open up the Word of God. Let's return back to God. Oh, Oh, yes, we remember what we remembered about God then, but the same God then is the same God now. Oh, get right with God and do it now. Get right with God, He'll show you how. Down at the cross, where He shed His blood. Get right with God. God bless you, Mom. I will see you in the rapture, and God bless all of you. Amen. Somebody prayed for me. We need to sing that this morning. And somebody, and let me ask you, raise your hand by a witness. You're not sitting and standing here or looking at me today because you prayed for yourself sometimes. How many will wave your hand and admit somebody prayed for you? Somebody had you on your mind, and use this time to tell the Lord thank you. Thank you, Lord, for Mom. Thank you, Lord, for Grandma. Thank you, Lord, for Auntie. Thank you, Lord, for that next-door neighbor who became my mom. Thank you, Lord, for that person in my life. Thank you, Lord, for that mom who I didn't like, but later on I had to go back and realize that you've given me some good advice. Thank you. The ultimate home security system is found in a mom who remembers the Lord. A mom who remembered that she was created by God. A God who formed the earth and formed this world. A mom who got up every day and refreshed herself by looking in the mirror saying, God made the world and it was good. And God made me and I am good. Sometimes mom had to love herself when she was mistreated and misloved by others. A mom had to be able to fill herself with the Holy Spirit when, because of duty and request, she had to empty herself of her own womanhood, of her own strength over and over again. And when she did not find human resources to give it back to her, though they made promises to love and to fulfill and to keep and to secure, she found herself broken. But she found a God who says, you can fall into my arms. There's no hour too late. There's no morning too early. There's no situation too broken that you can't come back to me and have a God who would tell you, I love you, dear. I love you. Hold on to the best. I say to you today, I thank God for the ultimate security home system. My mom was one who was from Camden, South Carolina. She taught me some valuable things about the church. She taught me about the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. She told me, that's the book for me. She told me, you stand on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. And then my mom said, son, though you are a boy who's raised up in the church, I don't want you to be a church boy only. My mom taught me some security system things. She said, you got to know how to take care of yourself because there's a devil out there. And that devil come to kill, that devil come to steal, and that devil come to destroy. She said, you may not be able to watch your back. God got your back. But if somebody's standing in front of you, my mama told me this, I remember that day in the kitchen. She said, if somebody's standing in front of you and they hit you, you better hit them back like a hammer. You my son. She said, you better not bend down or you better not resign. I better not ever hear that you done ran away from an opportunity for you to stand at your best. And I think my mom was helping me recognize that the home security system, it starts in your own heart. It starts in your own mind. It starts in your own body. And is there anybody who out there with me got some courage because your mama told you to stand up for yourself. Speak up for yourself. Time is filled with a lot of transitions. Things change. Things change. I remember when jobs would come and jobs would go. When the money would come and money would go. When things were good and things were bad. When things expected happened and then things did not happen as expected. But no matter what happened, I don't know what happened behind closed doors. But I'm so glad that whenever my mom walked out, she walked out with her feet firm on the ground. She walked out with a hope and a faith that we're going to make it. We're going to take it and God's going to work it out. Eat your peanut butter and jelly and act like it's some spaghetti. You eat your spaghetti, you better act like it's steak. But whatever you do, you make sure you say your grace before this meal. And after you get through eating that meal, you better tell God, thank you, because it took some hard work to give you what you got. Somebody say amen. God says, say mothers and fathers and others who are listening to me, that the best home security system is the Word of God. Open up the Word of God. Let's return back to God. Oh, yes, we remember what we remembered about God then. But the same God then is the same God now. Oh, get right with God and do it now. Get right with God, he'll show you how. Down at the cross, where he shed his blood. Get right with God. God bless you, Mom. I'll see you in the rapture. And God bless all of you. Amen.